thought I'd try a vlog. I tried one before, but my phone is just terrible. And it sounded like it was a wind tunnel, and it looked like I was made out of sand. So I decided that wasn't going to work. But now I've got a new camera, and I'm going to give it another go. I guess I'll talk about stuff every week that's sort of relevant or interesting. Maybe. That's subjective. But, and read a poem, and it will evolve into some organic monster, no doubt. So this week I'll just read a poem, really, because I've got nothing to say other than Happy New Year's Eve and coffee is good. Both of which are not life changing, are they really? So I'll just read you a poem that I wrote the other day. I was chatting to a mate of mine who's an artist, and he was just describing how he sees the world, and it was amazing. And I was just so moved and motivated by all of it. I was like, I've got to write this down. And I did. But then I was thinking about it, and really, the way he sees the world is the way any creative person sees the world, you know. This sort of place of possibilities and beauty and three-dimensional. There's so much more than just like the surface layer. And then the creative as well, is, you know, is a broad word. I don't just mean like a painter or a writer or a singer or whatever. You can be creative to anything, you know. You can do anything, couldn't you? Like gardening or sewing or cooking or accounting, depending on who you are and who you're employing. So anything can be creative. And it, I suppose really creativity is as much a skill set as a mindset. Anyway, it's enough of that. But I wrote this poem and yeah, I hope you like it. It's called A Different Way of Seeing. He watched as the man walked down the street at a pace and efficiently, and wondered for a brief second how that would be. He was not that man though, and he simply could not understand how you ignore, maybe not even see, life's sweet glow. He marvelled, each colour popped out from reality's canvas, each blink framed a new portrait, all beautiful beyond doubt. The artist wondered how it must be to see reality plain and empty. You could probably move quicker and miss less trains, he said, as his lips curled into a smile. The hazard of being an artist, though more than offset by the joys, the sound of a brushstroke, the smell of paint, the beauty of every moment. And as he missed another train, he saw a pigeon hunkered down, framed by the rain. And knew no other way of seeing would do. Thanks for watching, and take it easy, and yeah, see you for another one maybe, see if it works out.